There's a new character in the Batman universe called Punchline that everyone's going crazy over. Who is she, and why is this character significant in the first place? Let's take a deeper look. Welcome back to Comic Power. I'm your host, ComicKiller72. Welcome to another episode of The Quick Flip. This is a program where I go over comic book industry news in a short period of time. Please subscribe to this channel, and also click on the notification bell as well. It will remind you when new videos come out. Alright, now let's get right into it. The character made her publication debut in Batman issue number 89 in a very small cameo in the back. DC did some promoting for this character in advance, but a lot of people forgot that it was coming. She's not on the cover, and they forgot what issue it was going to be in. Of course, the demand outweighs the supply, and prices go through the roof, like they always do.
$45.
The character's next appearance caught people by surprise again. It was in Year of the Villain, Hell is Arisen, issue number 3. The Year of the Villain is a DC miniseries crossover. The character's third appearance in comics is going to come with some controversy. She's supposed to appear in issue number 92 of Batman, but was not supposed to be on the cover to issue 94. Apparently, DC has moved it up to put her on the cover of issue 92 to cash in on all this hype. But how did the character sneak up on so many people in the first place? Well, it's because a lot of people have not been paying attention to the Batman comic lately. Let's go back to 2016, where Tom King, who had recently gained massive acclaim for writing books such as Mr. Miracle, The Vision, and Sheriff of Babylon, one of the best war stories I ever read in my life. So DC handed the keys over to him for Batman, their premier flagship comic. And he started off good at first, but eventually over time, apparently he ran out of ideas, or the pressure of doing Batman, or the fact that it comes out twice a month, you have to have all these good ideas all the time, but it just started to slack. And Batman floppy comics were down about 40%, so DC basically fired him and brought in a new creative team, and that was James Tynion and Jorge Jimenez. And they are credited as the creator of Punchline, so when they took over, they wanted to make a splash early in their run on Batman, and they did just that, and they caught a lot of people looking that wasn't paying attention. After the malaise of the Tom King burnout. So the numbers aren't in by the time I wrote this article, but Batman was normally selling about 60,000 copies per issue when it used to sell about 100,000. So if the character catches on, this may be like Hulk 180, where Wolverine makes his first appearance. He's not on the cover, but he makes a cameo in the back, and it's his first published appearance. And here's where more of the controversy came from, because the speculator community was concerned that Year of the Villain may be considered another cameo and now full appearance. And if issue 92 was ruled the first appearance, then it's going to mess a lot of things up, because first full appearance is the key book that people want in terms of collecting. By the time I make this video, you still can order issue 92 at comic shops. It comes out April 1st, 2020, by the way. And you best believe the print run won't be 60,000. It probably will be more like 200,000. So the supply will meet the demand, so there won't be any aftermarket action on issue 92. And then the top grading company in the business, CGC, ruled that Year of the Villain number 3 was the first full appearance of Punchline. So in terms of flipping, Batman number 89 and Hell is Arisen are going to be those key books. Issue number 92 of Batman still is going to be her first cover appearance, so it'll have some value, but it's going to be a very high print run, so the flipping value on it is probably not going to be that high. But will the Punchline character catch on long term? That is a question. Right now, all we have is hype and curiosity. We know the character was intended to be a replacement for Harley Quinn as the Joker's girlfriend. Harley Quinn started breaking away from the Joker back in 2011 with the Suicide Squad number 1, and then issues 6 and 7. So it makes sense that the Joker eventually would replace her with another henchwoman, love interest, and cold-blooded anarchist like himself. Next up is Wicked Wednesday and a new comic book pick of the week. And the pick of the week for March 4th, 2020 is Strange Academy, number 1 for Marvel Comics. This looks like Marvel is doing Harry Potter and this is Hogwarts, because Doctor Strange has set up an academy for new young sorcerers so they can get properly trained on how to use their magic correctly. The headmaster at this school is Brother Voodoo. This character first appeared in comics in Strange Tales, number 169. He's a very powerful sorcerer, and he's long overdue to appear in a movie. Hopefully Doctor Strange too, but we'll see. Some of the other teachers at the school include other magic-based characters such as the Scarlet Witch, Damon Hailstorm, and Magic from the New Mutants. You have numerous variant covers like this one from Jason Scott Campbell, this one from Art Adams, and this one from Scotty Young. The students at Strange Academy are all new characters as well, so one of them may be a breakout character, and this is the first appearance of all of them. And Doctor Strange does make an appearance in the school that's named after him. Seriously, what's not to love here? Pick up your favorite cover and get this. The runner-up is going to be The Flash, number 750. This is going to be another one of those $8 milestone comics. And like DC did with Superman, Batman, Wonder Woman, they're going to have a variant cover inspired for every decade that the character has been published. So the 1940s cover looks like this. The 1950s cover looks like this. The 1960s cover looks like this. The 1970s cover looks like this. The 1980s cover looks like this. The 1990s cover looks like this. The 2000s cover by Jim Lee looks like this. The 2010s cover looks like this. And of course, cover A is for the 2020s. Long live the Flash. And don't forget about Dryad number 1 from Oni Press. This is from Curtis Webby. He's the same guy that gave us the critically acclaimed Rat Queens. It's more sci-fi fantasy that's influenced by Dungeons & Dragons. All right, time for some casting confirmation news from the web series Loki that's coming to Disney Plus soon. And just signing on for a role that has not been determined is English actor Gugu Mbatha-Raw, a 36-year-old beauty that I had been campaigning for her to play Wanda in the Spawn movie coming up. She's not only gorgeous, but she's talented. She plays the role of Plumet in Beauty and the Beast. And she plays Will Smith's character's wife in Concussion. And her best role as a lead is in Beyond the Lights, where she plays a fictional pop star, which looks something like Rihanna meets Britney Spears. And her character wants to break away from the over-sexualized image that her mom and her record label has established for her. What can you say, man? These British actors are just awesome. They're coming over here and taking all the jobs in America. Tom Hiddleston, who will reprise his role as Loki in the upcoming web series, also is British. So welcome to the MCU, Gugu. Marvel fans are going to love you.
You know the drill. Be sure to subscribe to this channel, give the thumbs up, and share these videos on social media so other people learn about the channel. And don't forget, I do sell comics at my eBay page listed here with a link in the description. One Stop Thrift and Comic Power are run by the same guy. That would be me, ComicKiller72. I have 100% feedback, by the way. And once again, thank you to my subscribers and viewers who support Comic Power. Until next time, this is ComicKiller72 for Comic Power saying, bye-bye.